Hey everybody, this is one of my quick review videos, and if you're confused as to what this is, what you're watching, and why it's not a full reaction slash review analysis video, make sure to click the first link in the video description below or the annotation up above my head, and that should answer all your questions about this new series. Don't worry, the reaction slash reviews that I do are not being replaced, they're not changing, I just want to bring you guys even more content in addition to those videos. Alright, so let's talk about On My Own by Amber featuring Jen Neo. This song was obviously kind of slow, kind of a ballad, not really my thing at all, but there were some really cool things that they did within it. First of all, this song has that really cool 6-8 or 12-8 triplet feel in the time signature, and the beat itself is like a really slowed down kind of variation of the Purdy Shuffle, which was also used in Rosanna by Toto. So that was like one of those music nerd really cool moments for me to hear them kind of doing a variation on that classic beat. I also really like the vocals. They were kind of smooth and eerie and soothing, if that makes sense, that combination of descriptive words. And even though Amber is this, you know, designated rapper, she actually has a really nice singing voice, so I'm glad that in the past couple months they've been showing that off more. And I also like the way they went about the sort of duet aspect of it, with her singing the high parts and there's that lower octave part singing right along with her in parallel. Some things I didn't like, they used that kind of corny electric piano sound that's like a preset on every Clavinova that was ever shipped out all through the 80s and 90s. But besides just using that, it was like very overly blared out and very mid-range strong. And the master overall I thought was incredibly loud, kind of over-compressed, and very blaring to listen to on my NS10s. And I felt like the mix itself also had some issues, you know, like the volume level on some of those percussion parts and the swells really kind of overpowered and came through the speakers and sounded really harsh, especially pushing against that extremely heavily limited and loud mastering. So again, to sum it up, not really my thing, but there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. I think it's a really good song, but I wish they would have executed it in the production stages and the mixing and mastering a little bit better. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. If you could share this video all over the place, Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, forums, all that stuff really helps me out, and I'll see you guys next time.